Today in the news, we've got even smarter TVs, more 2060 leaks, and an Instagram oopsie. What's up guys, I'm Snows, and this is your boot sequence. Before we start, I just wanted to thank our sponsor, Memory Express, which just opened a new store in Victoria, BC. You get the same quality of service and product selection, so this holiday, go visit your Memory Express in Victoria. All right, let's get into it. It looks like Samsung is going to fix a pretty annoying problem I've had with my home theater PC setup. I don't have one. I really only consume content on my PC or a PC hooked up to a TV, and personally, Windows is definitely my OS of choice. Samsung is going to fix that with a new feature they call Remote Access. This feature will roll out on all 2019 Samsung Smart TVs and will give wireless on-screen controls over connected devices. That means that you could plug in your keyboard and mouse directly to your display and it will wirelessly send the input to your PC. It basically becomes like a wireless thin client to your computer. Thanks to a partnership with VMware, they can work both locally and on the cloud, so you could access your data from anywhere in the world. Heck, you can even game from China while your computer's in Canada, although that's probably going to be a pretty bad idea, you know, latency and such. I think that it's a really cool feature, but so far, there are only mentions of input devices like keyboards or mices. For me, the ideal situation would be the ability to connect, for example, my audio interface to my TV so I can use my reference monitors. This would also be needed for someone who wants to, for example, use a USB headset with their TV/PC. I'm looking for a solution that can stream audio, 4K video, and USB data. If you guys have any solutions, let me know because I'm not buying a new TV just yet. I mean, I just finished repairing my TV's backlight that gave out a few months ago. Also, if you're gonna suggest something, just try to keep it on the cheap, okay? Moving on, it seems like we got some more leaks on the RTX 2060. I know, the last 2 weeks have been full of them, but what can I say? I'm here to report the news. So a Taiwanese manufacturer called CJ Scope mistakenly leaked the specs for their upcoming HX970GX laptops. On the leaks, we can see various versions of the current GPUs in mobile form, while the RTX 2080 and 2070 keep the same amount of CUDA cores as their desktop version, it looks like the 2060 will get a pretty drastic decrease in its CUDA core count. We still get the 6GB of GDDR6, we get a clock speed of 1320MHz with a boost of 1620, and we go from 1920 to 1536 CUDA cores. That's about a 20% reduction in CUDA cores compared to its desktop version. Quite the hit. On the slide, we also get a tentative release date of January 15th, 2019. That's just 4 days after the end of CES, so it's definitely possible. All those cards seem to be in the mobility variant in the MXM form factor, so the Max-Q variants will probably get lower clocks. Then we have Instagram, which did an oopsie. For a brief moment yesterday, a large amount of users, including some of my friends, got their feeds turned sideways. The regular up and down scrolling feed was turned horizontal and a lot of users complained, prompting a swift rollback from Instagram. As to why this happened, well, we're getting conflicting info. The Instagram head says that this was a small test that went broader than expected, while a Facebook spokesperson said that it was due to a bug. In my case, I tested the horizontal feed on the Explore tab only for a while, and I really liked it. I probably wouldn't like it as much on the main feed, but yeah, what do you guys think? Let me know down below. Moving on, and I think we were all kind of expecting this, the PlayStation Classic has received a price cut. The original $100 price tag saw a 40% slash to 60 bucks in the last few days, and I think that this new price tag is a little more reasonable. With the current hacking methods of the console, this makes it a pretty good buy for retro gamers. Let me know if you're gonna pick one up in the comment section, and let me know what legal games you're going to be playing on it. Anyways guys, this is pretty much it for the news. Hopefully you've enjoyed. Don't forget to drop a like on this video. You can click right here to see the latest video and right here to subscribe to the channel. It would be greatly appreciated. As always, stay frosty my dudes, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Yeah, there's still one more before the end of the year. So see you still in 2018, but then the next time it's gonna be in 20. Anyways, take care guys, bye.